Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.4 to the public. Now, depending on which version you had before, if you had iOS 12.3.1 or 12.3.2, it would come in around 347.3 megabytes like it did on my iPhone 8 Plus. However, if you are on the beta of iOS 12.4, it was probably over 2 gigabytes as it was on my iPhone 10. So just keep that in mind depending which version you're coming from. Now, if you're on iOS 13, you will not be able to get this without using iTunes to roll back to this version. So just keep that in mind. And also, if you're running iOS 12.4 betas, you can just delete the beta profile now, and that is found under Settings. Then we go to General. And then if you have the beta profile, it will be listed under Profiles down here. And then you would just delete the profile if you have it. Let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 16G77, and there are not a lot of noticeable changes, to be honest. In fact, the one we thought we'd see already has to do with Apple Card, and we haven't seen that yet, so it's still not present on any of these devices. So that means they'll probably roll it out a little bit later, and this will work fine for any device, and then eventually we'll just get Apple Card. Now, the first thing with this update is Apple has improved security on iPhone and iPad, so that's really nice. There's probably some bug fixes there as well, but the next thing has to do with wireless transfer or setup of a new device. So let's take a look at that. One of the main features of iOS 12.4, other than Apple Card, which we haven't seen yet, is when you're setting up a phone, transferring from maybe an old phone, such as an iPhone 8 Plus, to a newer phone, such as an iPhone 10, XS Max, or whichever phone you have, after you've actually acknowledged the account and paired them together already, you'll get a new data transfer screen. And this transfer your data screen now allows you to transfer directly from a phone instead of having to use Wi-Fi with iCloud. So you'll see it says transfer directly, so this iPhone will be ready with your data when you finish setting up. Time to transfer 15 to 20 minutes. So you now have this option if you want to transfer directly from phone to phone. Whereas before you had to kind of get some of the setting information from the old phone to the new one, and then it would pull all of your information from iCloud. You also have some other options now as well. And after it sets up your Apple ID, it will give you some other options. And under other options, you've got all of the old options you had before, such as move data from Android or restore from an iTunes backup. So it's a nice new little feature that they've added. Now, some of the other changes have to do with Apple News. So if we go into News and you've subscribed to the News Plus subscription, any of your magazines or newspapers or anything like that are now at the top. So it's a little bit easier to see. It's at the top of your feed and you can just get to it more easily. Now, also they've made it so that if you've downloaded that magazine and even don't have an internet connection, maybe you're on a plane, you have no connection whatsoever, you can still go in and read the different magazines that you've downloaded. So that makes it much more convenient, of course. And then also, if you've downloaded a lot of different magazines and things, let's go over to See All. You can download any of these. But if you've downloaded a bunch of magazines and then you want to clear the history of that, it now adds the ability to clear downloaded magazine issues by selecting history. So if you go to Follow and then you go to History at the top, if I had a history, I could just clear it here and clear all recommendations, clear all, or clear the history. So that's something they've added. And for some reason, the Apple News app is not working really well right now. So there may be an issue. Maybe a lot of people are trying it out. I'm not really sure. That's really it for anything on the Surface that they've changed. They've also updated the Apple Watch so that it now re-enables the walkie-talkie function. So they disabled that. Now they've re-enabled it because they've patched it. And then also, that's all the same updates on all the iPhones and the iPads. Let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. I ran those really quickly on the iPhone 8 Plus, and you'll see for the single core, we have 4,226. Multi-core is 10,513. Compared to the history, since this one was on the prior version, it's about the same, maybe a little bit of an improvement on the multi-core score, and that's really it. Everything seems to be fast and fluid. Battery life should be pretty good. It was fine on iOS 12.4 betas with no issues whatsoever. Some of the older betas had poor battery, but this one should be pretty good. I would expect you to be able to get through a day or two or a day and a half or so with no problem. And this is my iPhone 8 Plus at 97% battery life. And you'll see I haven't used it too much, but just today I've used it for an hour or so. And then it updated and I haven't even charged it. So I need to charge this, but we'll do a follow-up and see how it's holding out after a couple days. As far as speed and everything, landscape works fine. No issues there. 3D Touch is working like it does on iOS 12, not like iOS 13. So everything seems to be okay. Things are fast and fluid. Apps are opening nice and fast. Scrolling is nice. There's no lag or anything like that. If we go into my library here, everything's nice and smooth. So that's really it for iOS 12.4. Let me know if you've found anything else in the comments below. Also, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to get these videos as soon as they're released. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.